homes turn to ban. Vici Gaming's turn to pick.
Terror Blade.
E-Home's turn to pick. Seconds remaining.
Elder Titan.
Nirana.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to some more Chinese Wizard. Did you like my anthemic introduction there?
Have you ever taken lessons on DJ?
Yeah, that's actually the theme for the international. Yeah, they brought Deadmau5 back for a second year, and he came up with that beauty. Absolutely.
Did you give him some insight after the last year's fiasco?
I did. I said, shoot your camera, man.
Okay.
And he did, and that's what it sounded like. In fact, that was the cameraman's last dying words, as recorded through an underwater microphone. That's it.
Alright.
Well, here we have it, Lumi. It's me, you, E-Home versus VG Gaming. The other game, in essentially what the opening bracket, the upper half of the double elimination, we just saw VG Gaming Reborn able to knock down IG. This time, who's knocking down who? Lumi, in your eyes, is there a clear, stronger side here? Or is this going to be pretty close?
Well, according to the numbers, yes. E-Home, Tybrook versus Wings. So they had a shot to actually just go straight to Seattle. So they, you know, they're leading. Whereas Vici Gaming, Tybrook into the bracket to play on this match. So just based on the numbers,
yes.
E-Home should technically take this?
That's right. Yeah, absolutely. That's right. Yeah, the seeding, yeah, because the two just have the closest two. And yeah, as you said, this is the top guys against the bottom guys. Coming into the playoffs from the group stages. Draft so far, Elder Titan, Terrorblade. These are the players you want nowadays. Mm-hmm. The question is, in 1v1 kind of matchup, the Elder Titan's pretty good against the TB, isn't it?
Yeah.
But TB's still pretty damn good overall.
I think TB has like a 75% win rate around there.
Something ridiculous.
And teams are picking Elder Titan to counter Terrorblade, and he's still winning despite that, so... You know, who knows? But I think actually Mirana is quite good against Terrorblade as well. She's one of them heroes that could actually, with farm, you get the eggs, you get the blink, you go in and you just go bazap. And with the other Titan on top of that...
Oh yeah, so good with the aura.
Right. One of the problems that Terrorblade has, or one of the problems that teams have against Terrorblade is you don't kill him quickly enough. This team does not have that problem, E-Home. Like, they will kill him quickly enough. It comes down to Vici protecting him, it comes down to Terrorblade getting that BKB, getting the farm for the BKB, so... I think this is a good start. So there's also a different storyline. When Wings face against E-Home, they banned out Terrorblade and Naga, and seemed like he didn't have a carry player to play. So I was thinking that coming into this series, Vici Gaming will do something similar, just like take out Naga, take out Terrorblade. But it seems like, you know what, they say, we have first pick, we're going to take Terrorblade ourselves instead.
Yeah, that game, if I'm right to remember, that was when Isos actually fell back to playing Timbersaw, didn't he?
I think so. Yeah, was it Offlane Timber or...?
It was not. He actually played Offlane Timber. Okay. Because I did cast that game. It was yesterday, but it feels like ages ago.
With Blaze,
sure. Yeah. He actually ended up playing the Timbersaw again. But, I mean, Pix as well, I want to talk about this Storm Spirit. I mean, Storm, this is a very kind of particular pick that, you know, a lot of teams, they don't want to touch this hero. But some teams in the China region still do, don't they?
Yeah, in C2, we just saw...
And in C, yeah.
Was it Fnatic? Mid-1 was playing it with...
I think so. I didn't really watch that game with too much attention, but...
You were just casting, yeah.
Yes. But yeah, the Storm Spirit, do you still think Storm Spirit pretty good hero? Is it got its strengths?
I think Storm Spirit is actually very playable if you have a Storm player. And CTY is really good on Storm.
Yes.
I say really good because he plays... Like, to me, like the Storm Ingrid.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
He is the Storm Spirit.
If you have a Dota... player that could transport a game with Dota 2, he That's probably he might be Storm. Yeah.
The playstyle lore.
He's really, really aggressive. Yeah. And sometimes he's so aggressive that he like just kind of dies.
Okay.
That's so I'm going to be on the lookout for that one. But yes. that's CTY. They used to call him the 6-minute god because he is so good at delaying stage, at dominating lane. And Storm, if you get a good start, you can't just run away with the game. So Vici Gaming, from the way they're drafting it, they're just throwing shit at you, right? They're going to give you the Storm, they're going to give you the Terrorblade, and they're saying, E-Home, you deal with this.
Oh, I'm talking about E-Home.
Okay.
This might be another one of those games, you know? They say, well, you're not playing Naga, you're not playing Terrorblade. And E-Home, they draft the Timbersaw. And as I said, last time they did that, against Wings, they did just move Ice back onto the Timbersaw, onto the solo lane.
Yeah.
And I can't remember who that meant that they played carry. It was obviously...
Old Chicken?
I think it was Old Chicken then. Well, oh, yeah, because Old 11 plays the mid Mirana. Yeah. No, Old Chicken plays mid Mirana. Yeah, so Old 11 then played the safe laner.
I get these old guys mixed up sometimes.
Yeah, Ice Timbersaw. Obviously not enough to beat Wings, as they ended up losing that game. But Wings, of course, just... Wings are a crazy team. They're a lot of fun to watch, and they do win some crazy games. But, I mean, I guess not doesn't have to be Ice, but I think when you have a Timbersaw... It's, you know, Ice Timbersaw is so reliable. You just kind of have to move him back onto that position.
He really likes playing the hero, yeah. So if they pick it, I imagine he'll play it.
Yeah.
So the one thing about both of these teams, they're very similar in the fact that when they're ahead, they really like, they play much better. Like, they're the team that when they get hot, they just keep going for kills. They like to kind of snowball.
Yeah.
But they're not very good at keeping leads.
Oh, okay.
So I feel like this game, we might see a lot of 3-2-2. Like,
this is going to go like, boom, boom.
They're going to go ahead, and then they're going to dive a little bit deeper. And with heroes like Storm and Timbersaw, you know, the Bloodstone Carrier, that's going to get really out of control when one gets ahead.
Oh, hello.
And you keep the lead. The side, mostly pick for the Timbersaw, I think, as well as Mirana.
That is an intro. I mean, Skyraf Mage. I'm looking at that. It feels like this is a team that is very susceptible to, like, magical bursts. The Mirana, Elder Titan, Timbersaw, you've got a lot of that.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I think it's vice versa, right? Both teams.
I guess that's true as well, yeah. Yeah, if you silence them and burst, yeah. But I think, yeah, it seems like a very volatile game that could just go bam, bam. Team fights could go both ways.
It actually will be very fun for you to cast.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of action. Yeah.
I'm actually concerned for Vici. Like, if you look at the draft, if they're behind, if they have to kind of defend their towers, how are they actually defending towers?
Yeah, where's the wave clear?
You ask me, I'm the analyst. Yeah, I'm looking at these four heroes. Wave of Terror, bro.
Yeah?
Wave clear.
I guess so. I guess and the Storm Spirit is what rents, but...
It ain't great.
Then you got to get yourself right in the middle of the action. Yeah,
maybe their last pick would remedy this. They need a...
They still need what they're offlane.
Offlane, yeah.
Yeah. Any good wave clearing offlane is still in the pool?
I mean, let's look at the most common offlane. Like, Tide Hunter is banned out, Darkseid is banned out, Slaughter is banned out,
Void is banned out.
Phoenix, maybe? With a beam on the offlane?
Phoenix offlane. Sure. No.
I'm just thinking of something that could actually wave clear. And
do these guys play Puck? I'm guessing not.
It's ROTK. He only plays like three heroes.
Yeah.
And they're all banned out.
Tensor? No, not against the Timbersaw. What?
ROTK plays Prophet, but I don't know if this is a Prophet draft.
Clockwork? ROTK clock? Oh, what? Okay. What is going on here, Luke?
First time picked in division. Qualifier.
Well, we couldn't have predicted that. Right.
So he's also pretty bad defending towers. I don't know.
Yeah. Hey, Purification. That's a bit of wave clear.
Okay.
You know, just to say, hey, mate, go somewhere that's creepy. Cheers.
Are you here for Omni Knight? Do you like Omni Knight?
I don't know, man. This is... I'm going to be very interested to see what E-Home pick.
Okay. Well,
it's very good, I guess, against the Mirana, Elder Titan, Timbersaw kind of action. You know, Repel is brilliant this game.
Yeah, and you know, the way that...
And against Disruptor as well, making sure your teammates don't get glitched back. Repel could be... And it's really nice with the Storm Spirit. You know, a hero that doesn't really want to buy BKB.
Sure.
And he says CTY's playstyle. Someone like an Omni Knight's going to be able to support that and complement it.
Guardian Angel's nice for giving some armor to Terrorblade.
Yeah.
There's that. I just don't really get the synergy behind this draft. Is there any synergy? I'm not...
So how do you lane this as well? Is it just dual lanes? Terrorblade bottom with one and then like Omni Knight Scarf top or something?
I suppose. I mean, you could also just sack your Omni Knight and kind of just... Or TK, you do your best. He's not terrible as a laner. Where's Slax when you need him?
Slax knows all about this.
Isn't he like rank 12 on Dota buff?
No, he
actually is.
No, he's not.
You want to look?
Yeah, I'm looking at. Oh wait, I can't look it up actually.
I'll look
when it captures. Look.
I think he's actually ranked really high. All right, Dota buff Omni Knight.
Look for Slax.
He's actually like not terrible as a Dota player.
Player rankings.
All right, Sir Action Slax.
Nah, he's not up there.
He's ranked 12. Right, last time I checked, he was. Sir Action. Alright, he's not. He's terrible.
He's gone.
Maybe he hasn't played.
Maybe he hasn't played for a while, to be fair with all this travel.
Maybe he changed his name. Who knows?
Maybe once upon a time. Oh, no, he's there. I saw him.
You saw him?
Slax.
Slax?
Yeah.
He's ranked ninth.
He's ranked ninth in the world. Oh, man. Spectre, Ice. Okay. He's actually not going to play the Timber. He's going to stick to the Carol. All of them will play the Timber. If that Spectre gets a Diffusal Blade, I think it's GG.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at Venge and Skyraf, every haunt, they're just food.
This is.
Yeah. I like Ehom's draft much more here. I'm not sold by the Omni Knight pick at all.
But if Vici game and win the game with the Storm Spirit, it's going to be, you know, quite impressive.
Sure.
And but it is going to be hard. Ehom, the solid draft. And going into this as well, Ehom, on paper, they are the stronger team.
Yes,
so, Vici Gaming, they have got their work cut out. No doubt about that.
On the other note, I'm just hype casting this game where you have, like, you know, Sylar, CTY, Burning.
Yeah.
On the other side, you got Ice, Fenrir, Lanham. Like, these are just some big names.
These are the big boys.
Yeah.
Oh.
So, I'm pretty hyped for this one. Do you do the predictions?
I love the predictions. Yeah, let's go. Team with the most kills at the game end. I've got to go with the Spectre side.
That's a safe bet, yeah.
First player to get 15 denies. I guess Spectre might have a bit of trouble in his lane. Do you go for
against
the safe
an Omni Knight, you think?
If it's an Omni in the sky, might be annoying. I don't know, Scree, he'll still get in there.
Yeah.
Or would you go for the TB, Sylar?
I'm going to go with Ice.
I'm going to go with Sylar.
Okay.
Okay. Will there be a Courier Snipe? I'm going to go for...
Most games don't have a Courier Snipe, right?
Most don't, but there's a Storm and such. I'm going to go for yes, there's good mobility.
Okay.
And team of the first tower kill, I've got a favor of the side with the TB for sure, 100%. VG game is going to eat the first tower.
Okay,
yeah.
Alright.
Do you think?
It's all guesses.
You're going to go VG as well. I mean, you got the Terror Blade, haven't you? You know what I mean? It's going to be pushing down lanes. But yeah, here we have it. Game one then, in this best of three series. Laning wise, RTK, indeed looks to be on his own at the moment. CTY in the mid on the Storm. Burning's hanging around with him, but we'll almost certainly head down towards the bottom. John HYM on the Scarif Mage, and Sylar on that carry TB. Over on the side of Ehom, nothing too surprising. Old Chicken on the Rana, which he does know and love. Ice bringing the Spectre into this one. Old Lanham on the Elder Titan. Femra on Disruptor, and Old 11 on the offlane. Timbersword. Yeah, this is going to be very interesting to see, because one thing that you got to say for VG Gaming, I remember kind of time ago, Sylar Terrorblade was apparently something that these were very scared of. In the Chinese scene, this guy is seen as a bit of a master on the Terrorblade.
Yeah, he was actually the original Terrorblade.
Yes.
He was playing it when no one was really playing it.
Yeah.
So he knows this hero in and out, and he is looking at the rest of the scene right now as all these hipsters copying me.
He is a bit.
Yeah, he's an original hipster.
He really is. And laning-wise as well... Old 11? Alright, level 1 Iron Talon Timbersword Jungle. That's the plan. What do you think of that? Dodging the lane.
It is a very tough lane for him, right? A magic missile into, you know, a silence, for example, from Skywrath Mage, and of course the Metamorphosis right clicks. He's probably just dead, so he's gonna dodge it straight up. And reactive armor is actually pretty good here, right?
I guess it kind of works out, indeed, yeah. Straight up, 7 to 8 armor, mid lane, bit of action, Old Lanham and Cho'Chin come through, but interesting decision to dodge the lane. RTK, you know, this is now a bit bigger balls. He says, screw it, I'm staying in this off lane.
RTK never dodges lanes.
Yeah, he doesn't.
Yeah.
He doesn't believe in Iron Talon. He just believes in the omniscient.
He's also getting wrecked in lane right now, so I don't know.
He's getting a bit of XP.
Yeah, okay.
But as you said, it's not going to be the easiest lane for the Omni.
Yep.
But at the same time, I guess he shouldn't die. Once he's level 2 and he's got Repel and Purification, it's hard for Ehom to catch him out unless he's massively out of position.
Yeah, but the right clicks will still ensue.
Yeah.
With Salt and Jungle, though, that does free up the Vici supports. For example, you see the Skywrath Mage now just, you know, he doesn't need to be bought, so he's going to go mid and harass Old Chicken nonstop. And Skywrath does have one of the best level 1 harass spells if you want to dump your entire mana pool, as he's doing so. Sending a one Arcane Blast into Old Chicken after another.
This is some very interesting lanes coming out from both sides. Pings out to Old Lanham, he's hanging around the mid, but indeed this is a reward from Vici Gaming, spotting out the whereabouts of the Elder Titan. Yeah, it's going to be very interesting to see how quickly Old 11 can get his feet off the ground on this jungle Timbersaw. And indeed, if Vici Gamer can do anything to react to it, I guess they can't. This is the beauty of putting the Timbersaw in the jungle. It's unlikely we're going to see anyone head up there anytime soon. I mean, I guess maybe when there's a couple of levels on the Scarif and the Vengeful Spirit, they can look to be quite active across the map. But even at that, I mean, a ganking Vengeance Scarif. Are you going to be able to kill a Timbersaw? I don't know if you are, are you?
I think if they really want to commit for a kill, they probably can, like a smoke or two. But I think they're finding more value in shutting down the Mirana mid.
Yes.
Because Mirana is one of those heroes that, until she gets her axe, she's really just, you know, a random hero, maybe a Mirana ult or two. So I think they find much more value making sure that Old Chicken never gets off the feet, his feet off the ground. Because one thing that we do know from this draft is Ehome is really counting on that Mirana to kill the Terrorblade, right? The big burst nuke damage. So as long as you could delay that Mirana, Aghanim Scepter, I think that's their primary goal.
Oh, top lane RTK. He's trying his best to be a right nuisance. He's not got a lot of CS, but he is finding the levels against the Spectre. And in fact, managing to slow the Spectre down a little bit more than, of course, Silas TB in the butt. There's your first blood. Old Lanham blocking out the Skyraf as he tries to go up to the high ground, and Old Chicken jumps in for the action.
Okay.
Nice bit of a catch there for Ehome, getting themselves onto the board with that first kill. And they do need it as well, because as we can see, the mid lane matchup, obviously understandably from the start, it really is favoring CTRI incredibly heavily. And he's a full level ahead of this Mirana, and, more than triple the CS.
Yeah, I think in a true 1v1, it's a bit closer, but yeah. Obviously with a Skywrath Mage going into that lane, you know, zapping Ochicken nonstop, it is a little bit more Storm favored. I'm actually just more impressed with RTK being able to handle this top lane.
Yeah.
He's actually keeping up in terms of levels compared to the Timbersaw hitting level 4 just now. And Timber is straight up jungling hitting level 4 as well.
Dire's top tower. I mean, how long does this Timber stay in the jungle for? Is it just until he hits the 6? Then we'll maybe see him start to try and help out in the lanes.
Yeah, I really wonder that myself as well. I mean, you could go to the bottom lane as 6, maybe start defending the tower if the push comes your way. He also hasn't put a single point into Timber Chain just yet. He won't need it in the jungle, obviously, but once he does go into the lane, a single point in Timber Chain is the bare minimum to actually stay in the lane.
Mid lane. Oh, Lanham looking for the setup. Man, it's going to be the stomp. Can they find an angle for the arrow? No, doesn't matter. C2 actually popping the invis just before that happened, so there was no chance really for Ehome to follow through.
Okay, you're wondering when he's going to go back in lane. Apparently right now. But
okay. No Timber Chain still though.
Yeah, that's the concern here. He does get an immediate D ward here, taking away the ward at Burning Place. I guess he feels comfortable enough to survive a gank with a lot of armor and fused raindrop. But I think if they want to go both smoke for him, they can actually get the kill. Them being HYM and Burning on their support heroes.
No. It's going to be interesting to see how well they deal with Terrorblade, because as we said, obviously Silas Terrorblade is something that you are to be scared of. And this is a Silas Terrorblade that of course has had free farm at the beginning of the game. So Silas had the opening that you wanted.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll see if they are able to do anything to shut him down and put him back in his place. And it's also going to be very interesting to watch CTY. As you said, he's a very entertaining player to watch. And he himself, he's got free farm in the mid lane. Let's see if they can burst him down. Arrow into the Starfall. He's level 6 and he zips away. And I believe, yeah, what a time to be level 6 as well. Only just hitting it.
Yeah. The other level 6 I'm going to be watching for is Ice.
Yeah.
Generally, when you do get that level 6, you will start kind of move around the map and start getting the kills. He actually got the max death as well. When you do see, like, for example...
That's nice. I think that's nice, especially against the squishy backline of supports, isn't it? Because, as you said earlier in the draft, Sky and Venge, they're going to hate.
Yeah, it's nice if you assume you're going to get all your Desolate hits in.
Yeah.
I think Spectre Extraordinary Batman always maxes Spectral Dagger.
He does, yeah. He always does Dagger over the other two. Yeah,
yeah, so we'll see if the Desolate right-clicks are going to matter here as he makes his first haunt.
Look at this as well. 6 hits in, smoke gap. Okay. And it's going to be Sylar moving to the top of the map with Burning. This really is something that could catch Ehome off guard.
Oh yeah, Sylar really likes to make the scan, because right after you get this kill, you push with your Metamorphosis. So it's two birds with one stone, that kind of thing. Here we go.
Yeah, I see. I just got the Haunt. We'll see how he's actually using it. Yeah, he's just going to push straight away. And the gank is unsuccessful. I mean, there's always going to be an issue, really, here. I mean, they only had Magic Missile as lockdown, so at the least, I guess they can turn this into a bit of a push, but... I mean, looking at that kill, it was always going to be a tricky one.
Yeah. I mean, I think if they open with the Magic Missile, they still won't kill him.
Yeah, it's a weird turn. But maybe they were just hoping to... I mean, on the plus side, just force his Ember Horn. You know, you haven't got to worry about the Spectre joining to kill anyone for a good minute or so.
Sure.
And you're going to be able to take a tier 1. So maybe they're not looking for the kill, they're just looking for the action there. And well, meanwhile, bottom lane, Skyrim came into the lane looking for some levels on his own. Ice with the presence of all 11 actually able to find a kill in the turn. And top, They're actually moving in from Warrior Home. Eyes onto RSTK, who will repel himself, start to back up. Arrow isn't going to connect, nonetheless, win them anyway, because they should still find it. Leaping in, Old Chicken with a rotation, bursting down RSTK as they punish the point. So at the end of the day, it's just E-Home finding a couple more kills across the map, and also keeping their tier 1 tower alive.
Yeah, it seems like every one of E-Home's movements is basically countering Vici's movement,
yeah,
and also getting a little bit of themselves, right? You talk about bottom arrows.
And can't burst on CTY.
Yeah. But yeah, overall, E-Home just kind of one step ahead everywhere compared to Vici Gaming. And the key factor for all of this is that keep in mind that Vici doesn't play well from behind. They don't counter push well. They don't really do well when, for example, Storm and the Terrorblade is under farmed. So it's very important for Vici to kind of win these kind of few initial engagements. And so far, they're not really winning them.
But the farm's still good for CTY, but yeah, we yet see him be able to use this to transition into any kind of fight. So we've got Soul Ring done, but yeah, still a bit of time before the Storm really gets off the ground. Unless he's able to kind of combo with heroes like RTK on the Omni Knight. Application burst as he zips in onto a top.
Yeah, actually, there's not really much combo. There's just a pinch, I guess, they're comboing on, and maybe they're actually going to pop a smoke together right here.
They look like they are setting up something.
There we go. There's that smoke.
Towards top again. It's just them rear up here. But at least they could look to finish off that tier 1. So finally get that tower that they were looking for earlier.
They actually did scan the bottom area of the map right now, seeing Murano, or at least somebody there. So you know that this kill is relatively safe to get, but very important for CTY to not lack a glimpse. In fact, actually, Femur says, you know, this is getting a little fishy. I'm going to get out.
Yeah, a smart move from Femur. Realizing, yeah, this tower's a lost cause. They've just got to let it go. And elsewhere, Oldanam just finding levels of lane. Old 11 still continues to clear up the camps as he works towards that Octarine, picking up the Vit booster.
So again, like, every one of these movements, it's not like E-Home is getting a Roshan or a big tower kill out of it. There's just like small victories here and there,
yeah,
avoiding yet another gank. And I think E-Home is looking to set up their first haunt kill very, very soon. In fact, it's moving up top, I believe. E-Home looking to defend slash fight.
They do want to do something about this TB push. But at the same time, it looks like they're just not going to be able to catch it unless Femur gets the vision for a glimpse. Ooh. Just on the outskirts, they are close.
They're still really diving for this kill here. They could haunt any time to actually grant that vision.
They could go for Psylocke. They've got a glimpse. He's not getting it. What?
No. He already used glimpse previously on Illusion.
Oh, damn. Yeah, you're right. Sorry. Yeah, that's going to hurt.
Yeah.
That could have been a big kill.
Disruptor fact, glimpse auto kills an illusion, so if there's a big illusion in your face.
CTY, here we go. He's repelled up, he's going in ballsy. Femur will drop Static Storm. Can he get himself out with the repel still on? There's going to be the Horde from Ice turning up to the fight. They haven't been able to find the revenge kill onto the Storm Spirit, but they'll look to take down his helper. RDK will be the one to pay. Omni Knight for Disrupt there going on. As Old 11 continues his killing spree on this Timber Sword. 3-0-0 on the Jungle Timber. It's, is this something we're going to be seeing more of, believe me, the Jungle Timber? I want to see it in your pubs.
No, I do not. I think the reason that E-Home actually had him in jungle is,
yes,
at the beginning, they I think had him imagined in lane, but then they saw the lane that he was up against. It was like, okay, none of that. Let's kind of salvage the situation and throw him in the jungle instead. So this was not plan A, but the plan B worked pretty good here, as he is a 3-0 and looking to ramp up to even bigger items. So for me, the most important player with farm this game is actually Old Chicken.
Okay.
And he's doing okay. Courier right now delivering a whole bunch of stuff here. Okay, looks like he's going to build a point booster. Again, the reason that he's important is he's really their big burst damage. Like, kind of instant burst damage.
Yeah.
It's going to be, if you're going to kill the Storm or the Terrorblade, you need that big burst. So, for me, his Aghanim's timing is very, very key. And his farm is okay. It's not anything to be spectacular about, but it's fine.
On bottom lane, VG. Maybe looking to push in for another tier 1. Things coming out. We'll see if he can do anything to hold this ice. No haunt for 45 seconds. And he actually smoked up. I mean, they could try for some kind of wraparound, but the tower is already gone. And E-Home still holding themselves back in this position. Maybe wondering if Future Gamer were going to go in and look for a kill, but it's not going to be the case. And Ehome, not actually going to get anything on the back of this smoke by the looks of it.
Yeah, they're also slowly losing out in terms of the net worth. Future Gaming, because of all these outer towers they've taken, is starting to build a very small but sizable lead. So we're going to see a Moonlight Shadow being activated.
And we're pinged onto it. They want to wrap around as a CTY.
Nope. Mirana all ends. Now the illusion scouts everybody out, and that should be the end of the game. Now, speaking of catch, Ehome actually doesn't have too much. I mean, they have Haunt and Glimpse, I guess, as catch methods.
Yeah, I guess it's what laying down the Static Storm straight away.
Right.
Is how they want to look to try and catch out the storm.
And if you think about that from that perspective,
yeah,
the Repel really messed things up for Ehome.
Yeah, the Repel is great.
Yeah. So, I guess we're understanding a little bit more with that Omni Knight pick. So far, they have...
Oh!
What happened?
He hits an arrow!
Is that gonna be a kill?
Oh,
storm on top! Glimpse him back in!
Oh, old chicken!
Alright.
Hitting the arrow from a TP and onto the tower.
Well, I say that they don't have a lot of catch, but you can hit 5 second arrows. That's quite a bit of catch.
My goodness.
Yeah, that's gonna help him getting towards that Aghanim Scepter. Point booster already on the courier. But how do you feel about the pace of this game, right? Because, sure, you know, the game is going slow and Ehome's got 5 kills, but at the end of the day, you're kind of trading farm against the Terra Blade. Are you?
I would be scared. You've got the Spectre, haven't you? I feel that in itself.
Okay. Yeah.
It's still good news for you. I mean, Spectre TB late game. How do you think that pans out? Oh, 11. I mean, that's one way to deal with the reactive armor. Just blow him up with a bit of magical burst.
Not dead just yet.
Oh, he's gonna live.
Heal. Yeah, he's fine.
Oh my goodness.
Infused raindrops doing work.
Hey, goes back onto burning. No follow through. But yeah, that's a nice bit of play there for them keeping the timber so low. They will still lose the tower though, and Vici Gaming. They're pushing in hard. They may just go for a tier 2 push as well. Yeah, with the Metamorphosis, Sala ready to commit. It's going to be a question of what Ehome can do to stop this. They do have the Horn available from Ice, and he's going for the Vanguard straight into Diffusal Blade this game perspective.
So, you know, earlier you were asking how do I feel about the Spectre versus Terra Blade matchup.
Yes.
What we see right now is what I think about it. On one side, you got a carry that could actually lead your team into early pushes, taking early objectives. On the other side, you have a carry hero that's trying to farm up and essentially not really doing anything for the next 10 minutes at the very least. I think this is like the fourth or fifth Metamorphosis we've seen Sada use just to take towers. So that's how I feel. I think one is much better than the other. You could play with your team, take objective, and just really be on the offensive. Respector kind of just hope that your team could, you know, kind of salvage the game and wait for you to get big, and he is getting big. But meanwhile, we have objectives being taken left and right, so... Obviously, once Spectre does get farmed, then, you know, he could go for pickoffs, but Haunt is really only going to be too useful against the two supports.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be the support staff for the back lines. And I guess one of the things as well that's kind of nice for Sylar in these fights, if people are getting low and then the Haunt comes through, he can always send one of the illusions. And it's going to get him instant full health if he doesn't have anyone else around that is already at the max health on Ehome.
Yeah, that's the thing too. You know, if these two carries ever get into like a punching situation,
yeah,
the Spectre doesn't punch that fast, that hard. So it's very likely Sylar could get off a Sunder versus the Spectre. And that's where Spectre gets in trouble. With that said though, Spectre is building Diffusal Blade, and Diffusal Blade just hard counters Omni Knight. So they do have that going for Ice and the rest of Ehome.
I mean, what do you think the next play is really for Vici Gaming? Are they waiting for the Terra Blade to pick up a certain item? Does he need to finish off his Mantis Stell before they try and go in again? Or can they already look to try and look for tier 2s? Or is there no reason for them to rush it in your mind?
I think Vici, basically they're playing around their Metamorphosis cooldown. Whenever they got that up, they feel empowered to do something with it. And, you know, whether it's a smoke gank into a tarp play or whether just straight up walking to your tier 2 tower and take it, like we just saw maybe a minute ago.
Yes.
I think when that ultimate is up, you know, regardless whether he has Mantis Style or not, I think the Vici is looking to make a play, whether it's gank or push. But yeah, he's definitely looking to finish the Manta. There's some concern about getting an early BKB as well, just kind of respect the home nuking power.
Well, I guess the Repel. So that's one of the beauties for Sila. Doesn't have to worry too much about BKB purchase.
It'll be useful until the Ice Fusil thing.
That's true.
So eventually he'll have to get it. And also, you know, all the AoE is really good at building the mana illusions. Also, I feel like Yhome has controlled a fairly good draft with dealing with Terrorblade. But you know, this draft isn't just about Terrorblade. We got CTY kind of very quietly, but very quickly getting into that farm, and looks like both heroes simultaneously picks up the Bluster.
The same time! That's kind of...
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if we're wondering, you know, how the jungle Terrorblade, or Timbersaw doing, it's...
He's doing as well as the mid Allspur, apparently.
Yeah, Timber's got three kills, so...
Yeah, that's true, yeah. Yeah, Timber did some swarming turned into the last... But yeah, Bloodstone on both, it's going to be interesting to see who is able to build up those charges. I mean, the way this game is going so far, it has been Ehome, the ones finding a bit more action than VG Gaming have. At this point, yeah, still a slight edge for VG Gaming overall, though, with regards to the network farm and XP, but only slight small beginnings. It's still very, very early on. VG Gaming's smoking up. They're ready to go for some action. The ping's out onto Roshan. They could smoke and go for it with a Metamorphosis, but it's a bit risky, and Ehome are there with the wraparound.
Yeah, they're actually just using this smoke to protect Terrorblade. Look at Terrorblade. In the meantime, he's going to just punch towers. He's making Ehome to react to this, and his team is right there to back him up. And if Ehome doesn't react quickly enough, they just lose a tier 2 for free. Like they just do it right now.
And Ehome are just avoiding this fight as well.
If you keep avoiding, Sylar's coming up to your base. You got to react right now.
I gotta do something.
Tier 3 is not half HP.
Terrorblade coming into play. Ehome, what are they gonna do? There's your horn straight away. Hurley with the focus down first. Keep it burning. With the swap out. The mech coming through as well. CTY dragging an old 11. Keeping him underneath the sky. Mate, the Bloodstone's doing will get there though. Sendo on Tai Sai Sai. They're moving for more. CTY gets the slow. Quite the drag back. They won't be able to find that one. So all in all, only being able to force the Timbersaw to deny himself, still nice for them, the fact that he will drop down those four Bloodstone charges. So a little bit of a victory here for VG Gaming. And they're going to get out with that unit mode of Psylocke, yeah. Oh, with a repel. He doesn't care. He really doesn't care. He's gone. Psylocke's out. Safe. He's golden. Oh, 11 was looking to chase, but can't catch them. As VG Gaming, yeah, they got away with a lot there in the lane, taking down the tier 2, significant damage onto the tier 3, and making the Timbersaw himself.
Ehome, one of the big weaknesses of that draft is apparently they can't catch people, which sounds ridiculous when you have Glimpse, when you have Spectre, Diffusal Blow with Haunt. But in that last fight, it shows that, you know, unless you hit those 5-second arrows, when the team fight doesn't go your way, they can't really stick on a target and kill them. Like, Storm basically ran away with no mana. Ran away with no Metamorphosis. That's the time for him to fight, but they couldn't actually lock anybody down to take that fight.
Yeah. And kind of nice as well, I quite realized in the trap, but CTY still get a Bloodstone charge for the deny.
Okay.
Yeah, so he's happy with that.
Value.
One. Yeah, value charge for the map. Yeah, I mean, Ehome, what do you think happened? Why did they react so slowly to that? Were they just scared of the fighting power of each game? Do they just feel that they can't 5-on-5 at this stage of the game?
I think it's just scary. Like, for example, just think of it from Ehome's perspective, right? You see just Terrorblade punching a tier 2 without anything in the world, and four other heroes are missing off the map. You kind of find it difficult, like, which angle do we come in? Like, are they right behind him? Are they right next to the Jello? So, I think the natural response actually is just to hunt immediately, to find out the position of everybody and decide there. But maybe they all feel like without Haunt, we just actually can't take a team fight. So, kind of the slow and indecision, they just lost a ton of tower damage right from there. They're gonna take another fight here, and this one needs to be on their own turn. Just start things up with Psylocke.
Yeah, Horn as well. They're moving in onto Psylocke. They hope to repel him easily. Diffusal charge removing to get swapped out as well. Psylocke still brought back. They get the Glimpse and they'll burst down. Now they need to try and find more. Ehome jumping in. ROTK getting bursted low by the Shack and the Met comes out. Not enough to save him. He falls down. CTY trying to find kills in return. Playing around him. Old Chicken, will he go down? The final nuke from Sky does finish him off. But CTY, he's with it live. And Ehome finding three. They can't quite lock down HYM as the TP out will be successful. But I think there we're just seeing the power of how much this Spectre can do once he picks up this Diffusal Blade, even though he is now down to three charges. I guess this is one of the things, you know, it's a great item, great counter, but only for a couple of fights.
Yeah, I mean, he could upgrade it,
yes,
and kind of extend it for a couple more fights, but I think the big difference in that fight is they actually initiated the fight, you know, the Timber zipped and forced Vici into a running situation, and that's where Haunt gets really good, that's where Glimpse gets really good, and also, the key thing in that fight is despite all saves, right, Terrorblade had Manta Style, had Cinder, which apparently he could not use, had Repel, had Purification, and a Swap. But despite of all of that, Yiham still got that kill first.
Yeah.
That's key. I don't think that will happen too often, though. Psylar will look to BKB as his immediate purchase. And once the BKB is up, I think Yiham will get into the same situation as they were one fight ago, which is, we can't kill the TP. When you don't begin the fight by killing TP, you're in a tough spot.
I think Triumph did finish the Bear Scar off the back of that fight, and ooh, top lane, way! It's like an old chicken nice there, go off the ult and he melts. Vale and the Scar have made a pretty devastating combination at this stage of the game, even for your core heroes.
Yeah. I think we're going to see from Vici in the next 5 minutes or so is just basically running 4 Protect 1. Your Vici 4 heroes would just look for ganks,
yes.
Kind of farm up. And the real objective is Sylar farming towards the next key item, which I believe will be BKB. But let's see how ballsy he feels. The last fight really showed that he needed a BKB.
Well, what do you think about this one? Oh, RPK, straight off to the mech. It's going to be Aghanim Interceptor on the Omni now.
Yeah. I mean, Aghanim's allowed this to basically play really far, stay away from Guardian and help his allies, but I'm not sure how the real value of that is enough. Because, again, the bonus here from Yiham is magical. So, dropping a Guardian on Sylar, which is still fine, they can still burst him down through the Guardian. And they also have Diffusal Blade, which will purge off, you know, all the buff on Sylar if they want to. So I find that pretty questionable. I think the item I would have gone for in this is actually maybe Guardian Griefs.
Yeah,
if he gets silenced, actually, never
mind.
They have Storm, which you actually can't Griefs out of that, so never about that. Okay, I mean, RT knows better. Let's see if he's gonna turn the tide of it with the game.
Yeah. I think you sometimes see what Ethan's coming.
Sure, yeah.
He's getting this game.
Elance is great for Omni Knight.
Yeah, Dada still continues to save up the money. No sign what. I will go for next. And interesting to see that the Storm after the Bloodstone. I mean, it looks like with the Breeze, he's going back for an Orchid.
Yeah.
It's a relatively late one. And at a point where Timber's got the Force done. Elder Sun's building his own Yule Scepter. So I'll be to see how much that actually gets done this game.
It's still, if you look at the stats of the item, it's still one of the
Mana-gen
items.
Yeah.
And yes, despite this Yule's coming out from right, they actually want to get a kill through, you know, disables. Because Timbersaw got his chain, we got Umrana, so. It's a to be necessary evil, I suppose.
I did see Yiham come around with a smoke there. Yeah, I think. And so, well, Vici game have a smoke himself on the Vengeful. That's what kind of move they were for. I working towards a Manstar on top of his Diffusal Blade.
Yeah, with the Manstar finish, he could actually just get into a fight and just murder a support pretty much instantaneously. And I think the target that he's really looking at is probably Skywrath Mage, like fairly squishy.
Yeah, I mean, he's doing a lot of damage as well, H4M.
Yeah.
You want to take him out of the fight, you can't let him get down. His Veil and a Mystic Flare. Because as we've seen, it will kill one of the heroes very, very quickly on Yiham's line.
I'm very curious what Sylar is going to buy next. He's sitting at 4.2k gold. If he wants the KB, he can have it right now, but seems he's saving for the Ice God. Won't give you magic immunity, but you know, it's a ton of HP on top of what he's got currently.
Yeah, I guess he is just tanking up. And something else that they can maybe control some heroes on the back with. He's coming over to TP, but okay, there you go. BKB. You're back. He does go for the BKB.
It's just the safest choice. The thing about Ice God is, yeah, sure, it's a lot of HP, but it doesn't solve the issue of you having base armor when the natural order is on you. So
yeah, that's true. Yeah.
You're just one big squishy paper, where BKB kind of not necessarily solve that problem, but gives you magic immunity, which would help quite a big deal. Alright. And again, Vici will basically farm towards BKB and then they go for a fight. The BKB now, so let's.
I'm leading with CTY at the smoke.
Will be dispelled. Sectional blade down, but already the repel. CTY jumps off the cell line as H1 in the field. Guardian Angel comes up. Can they keep the heroes alive? They're dropping down the Mystic Flare cell and top PKP. Can't actually find any kills. There's the use for the cutting through. They've lost 3 VG Gaming and now. Let's see if they can get old Lemon and return. Now they can't. They'll turn towards Ice Ice, but he's kiting Sylar out. It looks towards old Lanham, but old Lanham as well. Oh, okay, they'll get that kill. Out well, Femri, you may have got a little bit too close for your own good, and Dorio gets himself out. So Sylar managing to find some sort of redemption for the side of Ichi Gaming off the back of the start of that fight. They still lose 3 heroes. As, well, gold-wise, it will indeed be a very, very close one. Really, no real winners here. I mean, if anything, Ichi Gaming are going to be happy with just the cash-in block that Sylar got from the fight. That fight was so weird. I mean, at the beginning of the fight, they blew up 3 of Vichy's hero. So it was 5v3 at the middle of the fight for Ehom. And they're like, okay, we're gonna surround this, you know, big monster and kind of surround him from all sides and come in. And Sylar injured Beast, despite having only ROTA protecting him. He's like, yeah, I've got everybody. You come here, I'm gonna burn you down. And that's exactly what happened. We had 2 heroes thinking that they could actually take a fight against Sylar, and they just straight up died. So the BK proving to be super effective in that fight. As long as he's alive, he just, I mean, he's the team's all of the team's damage is from him, so.
It really is. Yes. He just needs to sit there and punch people. It's gonna be easier now as well, yeah. RTK nearly has that out done, so. Extra defensive measures to keep the man alive. Ice has just finished off level 2 defusal, so the charge are back up and we'll be ready for the next fight when it kicks off. Tibisaw. As we saw, went for the BKB, so old Lemon actually having the BKB and Jules. I mean, this is a very defensive Timbersaw build, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. I'm surprised that he hasn't gone for an armor item, like maybe a Shiva's Guard of some sort, to basically allow him to survive a little longer, but I guess he recognized that, man, the silences are really dealing with him, despite the fact of having Jules. Also in the previous fight, I'm surprised that Vici, the supports, made a critical mistake. I mean, they were smoke ganking, but they didn't react fast enough to drop sentries. Remember, the fight started with a 3-man static storm on top of them. So, as the game goes on, I mean, you're up against Piranha. You gotta expect the Moonlight Shadow being used constantly.
I'm talking about Owl Chicken. Pretty much has the money for that inevitable link there. So that's gonna be picked up off this next crew wave that'll look to kind of up top. We have it. Blink now done. We'll see what BJ able to find with their own smoke this time. As before. Well, so it make a lot happen. Metamorphosis is available again. They may just go for Roshan here. Sylar's into the pit. Yeah, they want to explode. And Rogue. Let's see if Ehom are aware that this is going to be happening. They're making movements over towards the pit. Yeah, they send Spirit. Going to swim up. And VGM are going to be able to be very careful about how they commit to this one. And already just backing off there. They've very appreciative of the power that Ehom has to fly around the pit.
Oh, CDY goes to old Lamin and what?
Elder Sire, back to pieces. Arrow connect for the save. Old Chicken jumps in and there's your horn. Ice side issues, but it's a beauty. Well, CDY, he's going to live. Gets himself out now, but finally still goes down. The Spectre finishes him off. Now moving in for more. Old Lamin trying to burn down Burning, and he will do indeed. But at the same time, Sylar standing there, pulling into the members of Ehom. Ice says we'll get the TP out. Arrow from Old Chicken is going to miss. Jumping in, Old Chicken looking for the best. He blinks himself back off with the lead. Old Lemon coming in, they're trying to find more. But they just can't.
Oh, what? Again? Okay, just on the
can he get kills here?
He will try. But Sylar Metamorphosis is still going on for it. He should try to fight and he will do so. The Moonlight will come through. Old Lemon trying to get the kill on RT. He's got heal coming out full down. Actually, he got kill if he wants to. Heals, if he wants to use it. He's actually saving it for Sylar, I think. Doesn't it come out? He will clip on O11. O11 kind of going through the trees. Metamorphosis will end now. That will be the retreat sign for both teams.
And again, these fights, I mean, he's pretty unkillable as we're seeing. They just can't kill the Terra Blade. But at the same time, Ice is getting the kills done and he's not dying.
Well, not Terry dying, right?
Yeah.
And that goes back to the question that you asked about 10 minutes ago. Who do you want as a carry? Kind of going deeper and deeper into the late game. I think Stairblade might still be better because of the ability to siege high ground.
Yeah, his pushes.
If you're situation, but we're kind of just looking at fights. So Ice is really giving hard time to the Omni Knight, to the Storm, basically everybody that's not named Nighthawk. So both of these heroes really fight on different axes. Terrorblade is trying to punch whoever he can, whereas Spectre is being more or less sneaky and trying to backline. So.
Yeah, and also, so after the Diffusal Mancer, what does he go for next? Does he just tank up something like a heart? Or anything else offensive that he wants to be picking up on the Spectre? Does he himself get a Scardy?
Generally, it's heart, butterfly, or sometimes even AC.
Okay.
The two survivability, well, actually, they're all survivability items, but maybe butterfly makes a bit more sense to just dodge the hit from Terrorblade.
Is there any way he wouldn't have wanted to go for Blade in this game?
I think he's not looking to man fight a Terrorblade.
No.
He's looking to kill as many as he can and then deal with the Terrorblade last. So he basically doesn't want to be getting hit.
Okay.
Whereas, you know, the Blade Mail idea is you want to be soaking up some damage and reflecting them some back. A very interesting item race here. Sadler in that fight did have Crystallis. I think normally you see a lot more Eye of Scotty is a game, but I think he understands that basically in these fights it's gonna drag out a little bit longer. And it's gonna be up to him to deal as much damage as he possibly can in that short duration of BKB. Like he has to win or get themselves a decisive lead in those BKB charges. Cause once the BKB ends, if his teammates are dying, then he's kind of by himself. It doesn't matter he's healing a ton of damage. When he's not magic immune, he's in a lot of trouble.
Still, of course, at this point, we're near teams headed back into the pit for Russia. It is there for the takings. I guess VG Gaming's lineup, yeah, certainly better taking it. Better emphasis and, yeah, the support of Burning's Vengeful Spirit. So if they get themselves a bit, they can take it very, very quickly.
Yeah, I don't think Ehome would allow them.
No.
Ehome would very easily scout with the Spirit from Elder Titan. They got Arrow for scout. Of course, they got Always Could Haunt to, you know, basically give momentary map hack. So, we did see Vici try to look for it earlier, and that was a big play, because at that time, that was their last smoke. That was kind of their, kind of a big effort at themselves, a big lead. They failed the new smoke. They do have one smoke now, so see if we'll see another VG smoke play. This game, by the way, is really close.
It
look at the
close.
Network, it's 1,000 apart. I mean,
35 minutes as well.
Yeah.
That really is quite something.
The one thing that's not very close is Bloodstone charges. CY rode to zero Bloodstone charge, whereas Timbersaw sitting at healthy 16. And I do believe Timbersaw was the first one to die, actually, with a Bloodstone charge, right?
Oh, he was. He killed himself.
Yeah.
Yeah. So did knock him off and say, putting the Storm up to 13, but as you said, yeah, totally managed to turn that one around. Ehome, now let's reveal themselves mid, and we'll just go to take down the tier 1. Vici Gaming already with the pings up top, they all just look to check the tier 2 and train, already standing incredibly low. They'll certainly find that tower, and maybe even just push in for more, so that has Metamorphosis available. They want to force Ehome back and give them a real run for their money on this base.
They are coming back. My question is what Silo will pop his ult. Well, I say ult, but it's Metamorphosis. Which might as well be his ult. It's just, you know. Illusions gets murdered immediately. He'll make more. He's got the Manta as well. They're pinning him out. Actually, they're going to pop the ult.
Yeah, already jumping in the back. GA comes out from RTK. Horn as well. They're ready to go. Static Storm down in the middle of it all. Let's see why. Fine with the BKB, follow the disruptor. Xylar just punching into Ehome. Ice has got to head back up to the high ground. Yeah, Ehome losing. And if you lose the fight to VG Gaming will be ready to push in and pound into your base.
Murana doing a little bit too, trying to damage on this play, but there is that Omni Knight giving the sustain here. Push. There's the picture dropping. Terrorblade's gonna be. Imbersaw's gonna back me in too. And I think that's when we'll look for another fight. Diffusal Blade charges down to 3, and it's key. They really need to burn down the Omni Knight shield.
Oh, and they found a chicken. Old chicken caught outside the base. All the lemons on his way over. They're not going to be able to find any of his effects. Is that the lead though? They do so force feed off the racks, and they don't finish off the main racks with that push with the TB.
Oh, I think opposite. VG Gaming decided just through. After that fight, because terribly, Metamorphosis is over.
Okay.
So okay, even though we got the Mirage, we really shouldn't push without TP Metamorphosis, so let's just back. Vichy showing very good restraint here. And CTY, gonna build that Bloodstone Charge. CTY's also got that BKB running. And 3.9 gold, so...
Well, what was it? Just that stack still?
Shiva's is not bad.
Yeah, Shiva's.
Again, he's also working with the 11 base armor, so well, he's next to the Elder Titan. He's working with 0. And of course, getting extra Viv is not bad, giving extra slow. But should he actually go for the Hex, it's all the fine choice. Stupendous.
Well, let's see what they can find here. There's Vichy Gaming on the side. They want to have a go at this. Sipping in, they'll grab old 11, burning Anik Prime here as well. They'll burst him. Huge amount of burst from this combination. And that's really one way to deal with Timber. We see sometimes the Timber just running circles around. It's, you know, you're not going to be able to do that against the Scarif Mage. It's a fantastic pick against the Timber.
And that's a huge kill. I mean, he died twice in a row. Bloodstone charges are down to what, 6? His respawn time is really low now for a Bloodstone hero.
Well, what do you think about this as well? Ice. Instead of a defensive stat item, he goes back for that very late game rage.
Huh. 17% miss chance? Can that be right?
I mean, it does seem weird to pick it up at the with 38 minute mark. It's not sort of thing.
Ooh.
Done all the time.
He's dropping really low.
He's taking a few bashes, right? He already has it for him, but yeah. Interesting to see what he achieves with. As a lot of people are just kind of see what the kind of the post 30 minute mark questionable territory for picking up a Radiance.
Yeah, I mean it's just questionable whether this item is good at all this game. I mean it's improving damage output to the supports or the backlines is it's fairly good, I suppose. But I think at this point, 40 minutes in, you gotta start building towards of okay, how do we deal with the Terrorblade? Because now Kaida Terrorblade is no longer an issue. Now that he's got Eye of Scotty. Like when he's punching, you're not running anywhere. You're just straight up dying.
Yeah, I mean at this point as well, you know, Vichy Gaming going to win. You ask yourself, is it true that you just cannot let Psylar get the Terrorblade? You've got to ban it out first phase.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, because they had the chance pick to counter it. They did get the Elder Titan, something that's gonna go against good against his high 30 armor that he has at this 40 minute
right.
mark.
Yeah, like you said, this lineup is designed to counter the Terrorblade, but they're not countering Terrorblade. You know, on everything, it feels like it's Vichy that's... They're the one that's throwing stuff at you, and Eholm is not answering properly. Okay, Vichy will back off. Oh, there's a glimpse.
Yeah, HYM, Cup Chumlin indeed. Messing him down immediately, they'll find it, but they're jumping in for more. They've lost one in return. Psylar panicking the BDKB and punching into the lineup of Eholm. Ice, bringing up TK, oh, Chicken Jumps, and they burst down one on the sideline. CT1 was looking for 11. Zip straight back across. They've managed to set up all the goals. Oh, the damage from Psylar. Spreading into these people.
Okay, I mean, you see these two heroes trying to surround the Terrorblade, but that, for the... The fact is, they actually can't go in and kill him. The arrow, if that's connect, will be huge. It doesn't. Sylar's. Okay, you're gonna right click more. Gonna have to run, actually. Okay, they're running. Sylar's not have to man fight. He's not BKB. He's not fun. He's gonna straight up.
Oh,
I think it's actually worked. CT1 is out mana right now. CT1 needs to jump, but no mana. Arrow's actually gonna hit, and he's dead.
Oh my goodness. What a fuck. Very high.
They look really bad in the beginning.
Yeah. That light year, Vichy getting hard, but killing Sarah off, and the rest of it as well. Huge swing for the Dire. 4.3k swing in total. And that's putting them back in a bit more comfortable position. Eholm, very happy with the outcome fight for sure.
I think that fight alone really explained it for the Daedalus. He understands that, and he supports much down out as he can. On that BKB, because once the BKB is over, Cinder's use, he becomes very vulnerable, especially you know, with Timsadal, Mirana kind of jumping left and right, the Specter coming in and out of trees, and Eholm is take the Aegis, and will Vichy respond? And Storm's back in 3 seconds.
That's like it's not going to be soon enough, Eholm, getting themselves a free go at the bush. Aghanim's done to Timsadal as well. All 11 is that? I going the way of Ice. on the Spectre. A little bit surprised, actually, why the Spectre... I guess, did the not have a slot for it? I guess so, because normally, I guess, you look at the lineup, you probably see Timbersaur as the stages carries it on the side of Eha. Because Ice just hasn't died. I don't know if he's necessarily going to die at all.
Oh, the reason that he had to die is because he's really afraid, right?
Okay, so now you think they may...
Now he can shoot up his face, and I'm not exactly sure how well he punches, you know, versus Sylar, but he gets a punch. Whereas before, Panda just had to, like, sit in the trees, throw out daggers. So Eho might actually take a very kind of offensive approach, whereas before they're kind of playing the kiting approach.
Oh, with the money build-up as well, Ice, how does he, how's the slot push is he going to be going? Is he at a point where he may even look to put the Vanguard into the Abyssal Blade, or does he still really need to like, build up a stat item like the Butterfly Heart or Skardian and then pick it up once the Aegis has expired?
You know, I really like the Abyssal, right? Because the name of the game right now seems to be is outlast the BKB from Terrorblade, outlast Sunder, and you know, having a stun that goes through BKB goes a long way. So, I like that quite a bit. Also give you the nice 15 HP regen per second, which is not too bad. Yihom though, looking for a gank. It's a very tense moment. I imagine if we're going to see one more of this fight just that happened just now, I think Yihom is poised to win the entire game.
Yeah.
Because the BKB charges is really... I mean, it's already, what, a 5 seconds soon for Sylar? 6 right now. And again, for him, BKB is so important.
They don't have any more defusal blade charges though, so Repel is kind of going to come back into its element. And we'll top, look, they're jumping on Ice with a Hex as well, look at this surge!
That's Aegis.
That's why you give that man the Aegis, I guess.
Well, the offensive Ice play would not be possible anymore now that he doesn't have Aegis.
I mean, that's got to be scary though, the fact that they can just kill off a core that
quickly. Yeah.
Hex and a Sky Elf Mage, you're dead. Every time.
That's actually a very smart ganking choice as well.
Yeah.
Normally when you, let's say, fight the Eholm team when the Spectre is alone, he'll haunt in. But when you actually fight Spectre when his team is off ganking, well, nobody actually could bail him out that quickly, so... Good recognition by Vici. But regardless, it seems like Eholm just want to push.
Yeah, so it seems to be that way. You know, Vici gaming the Earthsmoke, so they're going to look to jump, and there it is. CTY zipping in onto Order 11. The Hex is there as well. No save for him. Timbersaw's down. And CTY moving in for more. He's ready to go a bit ham on the storm, starting to slow down Old Lamb. A little bit low on the tank, so doesn't want to go in for more as of yet. And the rest of Eholm will get themselves out again. But yeah, we're seeing at this point the Hex from CTY is absolutely destroying his lineup to the point where. I mean, can we look to someone pick up a Lotusorb, do you think, on Eho?
It would be good if they could afford it. But yes. I mean, if you look over to the Disruptor, he's got he could pick up a Blade Mail.
He's got 1200, he's getting to Blade Mail, yeah.
It won't be anytime soon, right? And you don't really want, like, let's say, Mirana to pick it up. I guess ET could pick it up as well. Yeah, I mean, I'm sure it would be a great item if they could afford it, but it ain't cheap.
Yeah, it just feels like they definitely need some kind of save.
Yeah.
I mean, at the moment, they've got the Stomp, but at the same time, you know, BKB's coming out and such. They need to have something reliable that they can throw down for a core.
I remember when the Storm was picked up, you were a little bit surprised, in the sense that, like, it's just not a common pick.
No, it's not. It's not at all.
How do you feel now, like, seeing, you know, the ups and downs of this Storm game? Do you feel like it's a justified pick for them, and do you feel like it has been working out?
Yeah, it certainly seems to. It's just having that initiation. And the fact that CTR was granted that space at the start because of the presence of HYM on the Sky of Mage, it is working out. As you said, he is still by no means is having a totally clean game. He has been killed a few times. But with just being able to always find that mobility to grab whoever you need to at the back of a fight, and just you always do the plus one. We're yet to be at the point where CTY can kind of stop people that easily. I mean, by all means he can with the Hex, but it takes a bit of time. And Eholm do have ways of getting themselves out of it. But it seems to be working out, and as you said, coming into CTY just and the Storm Spirit, just a hero pairing that he's very, very comfortable with.
Yeah, the other thing is that I think one of the big Storm nerfs was nerfing his ability to farm. Remember with the Remnant,
with the Remnant.
Mana cost increase. But if you look at the way that he's played in this game, farming is not that big of a deal because Sylar is constantly punching towers. Remember, like, the first 20 minute game, every Metamorphosis, he was taking objectives with it. That really helps Storm, catching up in the farm game. So, I want to say that these two heroes synergize very well on that regard. And that farming nerf, it's not as felt when you have all the objectives being taken. So now he's just the good old Storm, you know. Oh, still, his ultimate is somewhat nerfed, but you get what I mean, right? At this point in the game, the old OP Storm member TI5, he's right back.
Yeah,
still a very strong hero.
Yeah, thanks for the play that Vici Gaming have got going. Now, Roshan, still a bit of time before that one is back and available. As I said, Diffin is just off the heart of Tarrasque. And Vici Gaming with that position, we're looking to see if anyone came out across the mid lane, but again, E-Home keep themselves behind.
Who's got a heart?
Spectre.
Okay.
There.
Interesting.
So, I mean, this is going to kind of help a little bit with that Hex into Skyraph initiative.
Right, he's probably not going to die to that combo, or as easily.
Yeah, he'll have a chance of escaping with potentially a Haunt after the back of it.
You know, CTY is saving a bunch of gold. I wonder if the next item choice he's thinking about is getting Bloodthorn. Just being super aggressive with his item choice.
Yeah, I guess, yeah, Bloodthorn. Could be nice, I mean.
Ooh, clap! That's gonna hit him too!
Ooh, 11. Oh, hey! Coming in, Arty! Just bursted immediately! That initiation there from E-Home!
What?
That's absolutely huge.
Oh, Clemson's gonna get him back! He has no mana!
Oh, man. Huh? E-Home there with that play. I mean, they saw the spirit and they let's send them to sleep.
Did just like straight up like lose the game off of like 10 seconds of team fighting? I mean, that wouldn't even a fight, but Elder Titan, what a hero. What a champion.
There's a reason why it's banned out.
Siler's just standing next to the throne, like, hey guys, what's up, man? What happened there?
Oh man. Yeah, with that opening, that one play. Middle tower. Middle melee racks. And E-Home finding themselves in a very, very, very good position at this stage of the game now.
Yeah, very good restraint by E-Home, despite the fact that three heroes were still dead. The two supports are coming back relatively soon and Storm has buyback, so they just get what they want, which is, you know, just the melee, and they'll back out. That's a pretty big win for E-Home. The funny thing is that Vici still is leading in the net worth, but it'll update soon.
Yeah, we'll see that swing around for sure. Definitely past that 0 point.
And the other question I have about the picks is, I'm not sure whether I could say the same thing about the Omni Knight. Like, is that a good pick? You know, early fights, we saw, you know, a couple of nice repels. The Guardian has been okay. But, you know, even with the Agon Scepter now, I don't know if Guardian Angel has really a true effect in this game.
It does. It certainly does buy some time against what the Spectre's punches, but you know, just as we saw there, just the fact that the Timbersaw coming through and with the aura from the Elder Titan Spirit, you know, they don't need to rely on the physical damage. As you said, they've got enough magical bursts.
I mean, they literally died in like a second, right? That's all magic. Normally, when Vici draft, they always put ROTK on a hero that's leading the charge. Your Slaughters, your Tie Hunters, your Darkseers. And I wonder if he just feels out of his element. Oh, the arrow hit! It's a long one, they hunt in!
They want to go for a kill it. Will they be able to find it? ROTK with the Glimmer Cape trying to get himself out of there. Burning with the swap out, but it doesn't matter. Sylar puts the BKBs, trying to man fight against the side. Guardian Angel through as well. Old 11 being focused down. Hextop, can they kill him? Here comes the elf. Swap the other time, forcing them to move to the side, but it clips onto the Terrorblade. Three dead on PG Gaming once again. Oh my goodness. This is just falling apart for Vici Gaming so quickly at this stage of the game. Now losing 4, finding nothing in return.
Yeah, once some BKB charges down, they are just kind of Satan ducks. That Terrorblade, try to right click as much as he can. Which goes back to the Omni Knight pick. I mean, as a defensive hero, literally did nothing to actually salvage the fight. I really think that coming in game 2, ROTK should really put himself on that aggressive hero. He plays much better as, you know, your Void, your Slaughter, your Tide and whatnot. The good old trick to defend the base.
And it looks like they will back up. They want to go for Roshan, and this is going to be pretty much perfect timing for the respawn as well for Ehu. It's going to be right up now. Oh, is anyone going to check it post out? Someone go and have a look.
Send an illusion in.
It's there.
Ice, ice, ice.
It's there.
Alright, femoral check.
Yeah, I got it. Hey! Okay. So instead of going for Lotus Orb that you suggest, we do see Fenrir picking up a Glimmer Case, you know, standard good defense item. Landon's got a push staff, so pretty good.
Whoa! Okay.
Alright, let's make a game out of it. I mean, we are seeing that Sylar, they're saying, again, the same mantra. We need to do as much damage as we can during the BKB.
Oh,
so let's pick up Divine.
Alright. Okay.
Out.
Yeah, the Aegis is already going to go in the hands of Eo. My size picks it up.
Okay, burning.
Aye, rest in peace.
Are they fighting this? Oh, RTK went into Mecha's teammate, but now he's actually going to get caught out as well. Oh, like, half the team wants to fight, half the team is wanting to get out. Looks like they won't pay for it here.
Alright. Now, did they realize that the Rapier's down solo, or they just saw him there beat down? Actually, and I like this as well, though. Just buying a new defusal blade for the charge.
Oh yeah, this is great.
Yeah.
Well, it's not on him right now, so he won't have it. Okay.
CCY. On the ladder, burst it down. I just give it a bit.
Oh, the Rapier!
Sylar!
1500 crit, looking pretty good, Sylar.
Aye, punch. Sylar, what can he do here? Forcing Eheim back. At the same time, they're not too scared. They put the haunt, they move in. ROTK falling low as well as CTY. They've got to go back to base. Hex onto CTY. The Chakra's flying. May just get that kill. Old 11, he will. Rapier. I mean, it's reactive armor still pretty good against a TB with a Rapier. That's how strong it is. And okay, Sylar, he's lost the Rapier. It's on the deck. Take it. Ice will. I mean, it was nice to see. It looks like it's not nice enough. And indeed, GG is called. VG Gaming tap out. Ehome will take the game.
Alright. Really good play. So, I like halfway into the game, we're like, did they need a ban Sylar to play game two? Apparently not.
They can counter the Terrorblade, Divine Rapier or not. That, yeah. Yeah. I mean, I gotta say, Elder Titan was really doing it in those fights.
Yeah, he hit some really big ults. That one where they pushed off the mid racks, I mean, two-man clap into just bazap.
Yes. Elder Titan's play. Timbersaw as well, old 11 Timbersaw was really nice. It was really good. A nice ice. Literally a flawless game.